Michael Wood was advised by officials half a dozen times to sell his shares in Auckland Airport. His failure to comply now costing him his job as Transport Minister, at least for the moment. It's another ministerial drama for Labor, with the opposition leader pointing out the clear conflict of interest. Here's political editor Jessica Mutch McKay.
Michael Wood is known as a cautious minister. Shown here wheeling his bike, he knows riding in front of cameras often doesn't end well. But today, a fall from grace has seen him temporarily stripped of his transport portfolio.
So I have to take my medicine around this, and I have to put these two things right.
I think it is an unacceptable situation for him to find himself in, and therefore I think the best thing to do is stand him down while he does resolve those matters.
It's about $13,000 in Auckland Airport shares he bought as a teenager and thought were in a trust. When he discovered they weren't, he didn't declare them properly and forgot to get around to selling them, even though he said he would multiple times, all while being Transport Minister.
If I think because they had an old email address, and in the reality of the fairly busy life that I have, I didn't get back to it.
Well, it's pretty easy to sell shares. $13,000 of shares, you're just selling shares, as I would have thought. You know, so it's not rocket science to be able to sell shares.
I'm not sure that there really is an adequate explanation for something like this. It's clearly been on his to-do list and he hasn't done it. And that's not okay. He should have done it.
He'll stay on as the Minister for Auckland and Immigration. And once it's sorted, he'll be back in the job.
I don't think the transgression is one that is so significant that he should lose his job altogether.
Look, I think this is more sloppiness than evil or dishonesty, but people do have a right to know. He should have filled his forms out right.
The Prime Minister's staff found out on Friday, but Chris Hipkins was only told last night.
I would have stood him down last Friday when I first found out about the issue.
I believe in natural justice.
John Key was caught out not declaring shares in Transrail.
The public of New Zealand have a right to know if ministers have interests in the business entities that they are dealing with.
It's been a rough ride recently. Stuart Nash, Mecca Faitere, Kitty Allen, Jan Tinetti, and now Michael Wood.
Minister, you are a bit of a Mr. Fix-It for Labor. You're the person they bring in when people are in trouble. Do you feel this more keenly because of that?
I feel it keenly because I made some mistakes here. I got something wrong. That has created a distraction.
A distraction Labor could do without, and he knows it.
And Jess is with us now live. Kia ora, Jess, take this forward. What happens now?
Well, once he's actually sold the shares, which you can imagine after today will be a top priority for the minister, and once he corrects the record, which is the list of financial interests for MPs, he can come back as the Transport Minister, and that could be just a number of days. One of the reasons this is so frustrating for the Prime Minister is that Michael Wood has a reputation for being diligent, for being meticulous. He's been in this place for a long time, and he has big portfolios. So this really was a big one for him to get wrong.
No doubt the Prime Minister's also worried by another minister in trouble. It's not a good look, is it?
One of the key things in all of this is that Michael Wood was told at least five times over 3 years to sell the shares, and it just doesn't make sense why he didn't get around to it for so long. One of the reasons this is so damaging is because it comes down to the fundamentals of this place. If you have financial interest in something, you can't be making decisions around it, and if you do, it needs to be declared, it needs to be transparent, you need to manage that. This, yet again, is another Labor minister having an own goal. We've seen that a few times this year, and no one in this place needs to be told that it's only 4 months until New Zealanders get to decide who gets to stay and who goes.